Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Jorge and today I would like to show you an interesting project I've been working for a while, an animatronic head. I was inspired by the work of Will Cogley, who designed an animatronic mouth and eye mechanism and shared them on his YouTube channel, which is featured in the link below. I did some research on animatronics, I saw the things that Disney and other companies do. Then I began to model a skull on Blender. I used a wheel's mouth mechanism as a starting point, then I added a double hinge system highlighted in the 3D model to have a protruding jaw effect. I also designed a simple mechanism to allow the jaw to move sideways. Then I created a lower jawbone that protects the inner mechanisms and has enough clearance to allow them to move without interference. I also developed a lip muscle. It will be 3D printed on rubber. I extended and twisted the side muscles to reach the corners of the lips. For the eye mechanism, I developed a hybrid between mechanics and real muscles. I want the eyeballs to move using rubber muscles and only two servos. The eyelids will be very standard and will move independently. I'm also considering the work of Mesmer Engineering Arts, who did a compact mechanism closer to a clockwork. I will also have to find and fit cameras in the eyeballs. I simplified the skull to make it 3D printable. It has flat surfaces to fit the Arduino card and other electronic components. The front of the skull is detachable and will contain the eye mechanism. It also has enough clearance around the nose to allow the lip muscles to move freely. For the eyebrow mechanism, I research what's on the market, but I also study expressions and my own face too. I measured the distances and angles, then I translated that to a lever mechanism. The bridge joining the servos has a flat surface to fit the Arduino card. The neck mechanism will be very standard too. Three servos will rotate the skull up and down and sideways while pivoting on a central sphere. The whole neck will rotate from its base using another servo. I'll make the face on silicone using the model you see on the screen. I already printed that model to check the real dimensions and how the proportions work. I'll then adjust the model by hand using clay. The next step will be modeling the wrinkles from the inner surface to create real expressions. I'll have to create different thicknesses for each area of the face. In conclusion, I'll have to further develop and adjust all the mechanisms to fit the skull and have enough clearance between them. I'll make animations of all the moving parts to check that everything works right. Then I'll 3D print all the parts and start adjusting the servos. Well, I hope you have enjoyed this introduction, and if you like this video, click the like and subscribe button to follow this project, and feel free to leave comments too. Thanks for watching.